March 30th, 2020, episode 6 of The Good News Show. We got a lot to talk about today, so here's some good news for you. Here's some good news for ya. Anyway, on to the news for today, because this is a big one. So I was on Instagram last night and I got a message telling me that there's another good news show out there. Check this out.
Good evening, everybody.
Oh my God.
Even though it is very clearly the afternoon.
It's that guy from The Office.
SGN. John.
It's Jim from The Office. And he's got his own good news show.
What is SGN? That's a good question. For years now, I've been wondering, why is there not a news show dedicated entirely to good news?
What?
Well, desperately seeking my fix somewhere else, I reached out to all of you this week, asking, nay, begging, for some good news.
Okay, 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 okay.
After reading those...
Pause. I got three comments to make. Number one, I think it's amazing that this kind of content is trending on YouTube. It shows me that there is an audience for this and that the idea of good news is just what we need in this moment. Number two, I'm kind of jealous of his sign. He's got the SGN sign in the background. I feel like I should have a sign for my show. I just kind of have a door and a chair. Okay, wait a second. Yeah, that's better. Okay, and now thing number three, I notice he's wearing a suit and it makes me feel kind of underdressed for this kind of news show. But I do have these cool indoor house slippers that I've been wearing. Yeah, I bet you don't have these, do ya? Jim from The Office. Okay, anyway, in all seriousness, the video is called Some Good News with John Krasinski. And it is currently number one trending on YouTube. That alone is good news for me. The fact that there's more positivity being spread and there's more people using this moment to change the narrative of how we feel around the state of the world. I'm gonna be watching his show and I'm sure he'll be watching mine too. Yeah, I think we have about an equal audience at this point. Anyway, the main story for today is something from my own country, Canada. And, okay, so I gotta intro this one a little bit. You guys remember the toilet paper shortage? I mean, some of you probably remember it every time you go to the bathroom and you see you're down to your last roll. But I think it was like 2 or 3 weeks ago when everyone was talking about the toilet paper shortage. And yeah, I found out where all the toilet paper is. It's making videos like this. You see, they're all in different cities across Canada. Yeah. That's Winnipeg, my hometown. Represent. Yeah, it goes across the whole country. It's got people from Quebec, it's got people from Winnipeg, it's got people from Nova Scotia, Ontario. It's just a cross-country toilet paper challenge. Wait for it, wait for it. The ending is so good. I'll put a link for that one in the description as well for anyone who... Oh, focus, focus. There we go. Yeah, for anyone who wants to see the toilet paper challenge across Canada. And yeah, if you do want to make your own toilet paper challenge, yeah, you can use a hockey stick or whatever, but make sure that you are using the toilet paper afterwards, because it's a very valuable commodity these days. You don't want that paper gold to go to waste. And yeah, that's about it. I have a few more stories that I found this weekend, but I think I'll save those for the next episode. Before I go, I just want to leave you with one final thought. This is something I was thinking about a lot over the weekend. as you guys know, I did a couple of live stream videos this weekend, and it was very spontaneous. I hadn't really planned to do that. I just woke up on Saturday and I felt really down about the state of things. I just had a bad day. What can I say? I just had a bad day, and I decided I don't want to do the Good News show when I'm feeling this way. Then a couple hours later, I thought, you know what? Why don't I just go do a live video and connect with you guys, and we can talk and hang out. And it immediately brightened my day. It made my day a lot better, and I hope it made some of your days better too. So I might do more live stream videos on the weekends, maybe make that a tradition just to hang out and talk and ask questions and just to stay connected, because I think if there's one thing that all these good news things have in common is it's people finding ways to connect, even in this weird world that we're living through. We all gotta stay connected. We all need to reach out to friends and families. We all need to just be there for each other. And that's what I'm trying to do with this channel. So for anyone who's watching, for anyone who's out there, thank you once again. Hope you have an awesome day. And if you don't have an awesome day, if you're feeling down, just remember that happens to everyone. It happens to me, I'm sure it happens to, you know, Jim from the office as well. We all have these moments when it all gets to be too much. And that's okay too. But when you can, come back to the positivity, because that negative stuff will just drag you down. So that's my thought for today, guys. And yeah, there's some good news for you. Here's some good news for you.